Hi, and welcome to this video tutorial on the oral DARF in the PMB Investigational Drug Accountability Series. This video will review recording procedures when using the NCI Investigational Agent Accountability Record Form for oral agents, or oral DARF. You can find the oral DARF here on the CTEP website forms page. The oral DARF must be used for NCI studies using an oral agent, either open label, protocol specific, or blinded patient specific. Please continue to use the original NCI DARF for all formulations not intended for oral administration. The difference between the two DARFs is that the oral DARF provides additional columns to document patient returns. These fields provide space for sites to record quantities of oral agents returned by patients. The site should not return dispensed oral agents to the NCI clinical repository. Patient returns should be destroyed on-site in accordance with the institutional policy. Let's review the individual fields unique to the oral DARF. Bottle size is an additional field that appears in the oral DARF header section. This information is used as a link between the quantity dispensed and the quantity returned. The first additional column is expiration date. In many cases, this information will not be available. If the expiration date is not available at the time of agent receipt, it is not necessary to add it later to all prior line items where the lot was dispensed or returned. At the time the expiration date is known, it can be added for all line items recorded for the lot from that point forward. The next column is date patient returned. Record the date received in the dispensing area. It may differ from the actual date received in the clinic. The quantity patient returned is located next, just to the right. If the quantity returned cannot be easily counted, such as suspensions or solutions, you may record returned quantities as full or partial. Returns of sealed bottles do not need to be opened for physical count. Unsealed patient returns should be opened, counted, and recorded. Intact bottles should be recorded as quantity of bottles. The oral DARF is formatted for dispensing and return information to appear in the same row. When rows of the oral DARF are used to record activities other than dispensing, the return columns will not be used. When a patient return is received, look at the label of the returned agent and find the correct oral DARF by verifying information in the header section, such as protocol, investigator, agent, formulation, and strength. Next, locate the correct dispensing row for the returned drug by matching the date dispensed, patient initials, patient ID number, and lot number to the row in which the dispensing was recorded. Now let's go through some different examples of what steps to take when a patient return is received. In the example on line 2, one bottle contained 16 tablets of bisoprenib hydrochloride was returned to the dispensing area for patient AZ1234-001. The tablets were 200 mg of lot GLX12345678 used in NCI protocol 1234 and dispensed on March 24, 2014. In the example on lines 12 and 13, two lots were dispensed to patient BT1234-002 on July 23, 2014. Each dispensing is recorded on a separate line, and the return is recorded correctly on the corresponding line for each lot. Multiple lots of agent dispensed on the same date must be recorded on separate lines of the DARF. Okay, what if a patient returns an empty bottle? In that case, there's nothing to record, such as on line 6 or 7. Keep in mind that the patient return columns are not intended to document destruction of oral agents or adherence to prescribed therapy. Patient adherence should be measured as described in the protocol. Okay, let's look at another patient return on line 5. In this case, four partial bottles were returned from a single dispensing on May 16, 2014. The bottles each contained 6 tablets. Count and add up the number of tablets from each bottle to record the total quantity returned, which is 24 in this example. For the final example, let's review the steps to take when additional bottles are returned from a single dispensing but on different dates. The return fields in the dispensing row on line 3 were completed previously, so you'll need to go to a new line. Starting with the next blank row, line 9 in this example, reference the dispensing date, including oral DARF page number and line number. then record in the return columns. Lastly, keep in mind if clinical supplies are not returned to the dispensing area, there will be nothing to record in the return columns on the oral DARF. And remember, the oral DARF must be used for all NCI studies using oral agents. The same steps described in this video should be taken when recording on patient-specific oral DARF. The only difference with a patient-specific supply is that the Julian date and the order number are used as the lot number. Information on patient returns is also available in the PMB FAQ Patient Returns of Oral Clinical Supplies, available here on the PMB website. Thank you for watching this video tutorial. Additional PMB investigational drug accountability videos are available through your YouTube playlist. Please note that the video and any items displayed within the video are subject to change. Check back periodically for updates. Questions can be directed to the Pharmaceutical Management Branch, CTEP, NCI, by phone Monday through Friday from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time, or by email at any time. Thank you.